We're at the LeMaster Dairy Farm at Clemson University, and I'm speaking with Steve Wagner, who's the manager of the Dairy Herd. Steve, thank you so much. And this has been one of the most remarkable tours I've ever had, I must say, to start off. Talk about what y'all did with this cutting-edge facility, the things that are incorporated into it, please.
We started looking at this about 5 or 6 years ago as far as we were going to have to do something. The old facilities were at a point that they were basically wore out and we were going to need to do something. So we hired some people that are very knowledgeable of what they do and how they design these facilities, but we looked at this facility and incorporated robotics into it as a kind of a cutting edge thing that was actually coming on now to benefit labor, health, and all those issues that we deal with the dairy cattle on a daily basis.
And this has been designed for the comfort and health of the cow. And so the design of the building is quite unusual compared to what we're used to seeing. It seems very open and airy.
Yeah, what we're seeing nowadays is what the design of these new dairy facilities is cow comfort. And what we're finding out, these high eaves, high roofs, draw natural ventilation. We actually put this dairy up on this little hillside, you know, with a west-east thing to draw the natural ventilation and the air through. And you can tell a big difference, especially in summertime, with the fans and sprinkler systems we have to cool these cows.
And you even have, apparently they enjoyed the tactile sensation of having a brush their back scratched.
Yeah, they have the cow brushes down there for their comfort as well. And you know, you'll see cows fighting over them sometimes to get to them. So they like those also.
And they are working hard making milk, and they do occasionally like to lie down. So you have an unusual bedding system for them.
Yeah, we use sand, recycled bed, sand bedding to keep the cows comfortable. So the cows are either laying down, producing milk, or eating. You know, that's what your goals are, is to have the cows back in a comfortable position to make milk.
And the bedding is designed so that the rear end of the cow is kind of hanging out over a gully, and that allows the solid waste to generally land in that gully. And I believe people aren't having to go out there and push brooms. You're using water flow to flush that?
Yes, we're recycling water from our lagoon to basically flush away all the solid materials and the sand. The sand is settling out and we're reclaiming that sand through a wash system. But the cow stalls are designed for those cows to be kind of sticking out into that alleyway so that manure naturally falls in the alleyway to be flushed and not landing in the bed for them to relay in.
But then the cows have, first of all, I think they've got one of those fitbits.
It's kind of a cow fitbit, but it's actually called a pedometer where it measures their steps, which helps us with repro issues. And also it can also identify cows being maybe a little sick and a little off feed where they're not moving as much. You know, they're not making as much efforts to get to the feed or the milk parlor, so you can see that too.
Since there is a gateway into the robotic milking machine, I believe that's controlled by an electronic device in their ear. Can you explain that to us, please?
Yeah, the RFID tag in their ear controls pretty much everything the cow does. When she hits the entry gate, it picks up her information and sends it in the computer. The robotics are all tied to the computer. Once she gets the determination if she's ready to be milked, she's put into the robot pen. Once she enters the robot, it picks up that tag again and tells that robot how much her expected production should be on each quarter.
How does the milk get out of the cow?
Basically by the milking machines.
But explain that.
They're set up on a vacuum thing, whereas they are on and off at like a 60-40 ratio. It's just like you were milking a cow by hand. You know, that control is kind of the same control that's in that teacup that actually milks that quarter out.
And they're washed and various things in between. And you said that this is an improvement over the older machines where every teat was stripped and treated as if they were all for the same, where actually each one has a different supply of milk.
Right, each quarter gives a different amount, and you can see all that information in the robot computer. And like I say, this is a better, if we think it's going to be a better thing for health issues because of the cows not being over milked. You know, more with the old system, you put all four on, they stayed on all four till they come off. Whereas now they come off individually as a cow finishes milking in that quarter.
And this also lets you see as the milk production hits its apex, and then as it begins to decline, and that's a symbol, it tries to help, that indicates to you when they would be inseminated and when they would be put out again to the pasture and dried out for a while.
Well, everything is tracked through the computer that's hooked to the robots. Every cow that comes through is milked every quarter, and it actually tracks that and gives you up. It'll put you out a graph showing you what her lactation is doing.
Y'all have a very large holding tank. Is that where the milk is stored? And how often does the trucks have to come, and where is it going?
The trucks pick up every 3 days. Mm-hmm. South Carolina allows a three-day pickup. It's actually picked up here and goes to our co-op to be marketed wherever it needs to go. They actually, you know, test every tanker it goes in for antibiotics and stuff like that. So it's a real stringent thing it goes through before it leaves here.
Even coming from such a facility, there are always safeguards in place to protect the public.
Right.
You still have green pastures with cows in them. And who are the cows who are out of the green pastures?
All the cows in the outside pastures now are the young stock that's coming in to replace these cows. We hope we'll have better genetics in the next generation of animals that are coming out. And also our dry cows, once they get that little rest period before coming back into production, they're turned out on pasture.
So the ones that are inside are being actively milked?
Right. The cows under this facility are being actively milked here.
Well, and they are under a watchful eye. While I've been here, you've taken out your phone and looked at it several times. You told me that at home, there's several people who receive alerts in case anything does go wrong. This is the most incredibly monitored cow comfort and health facility that exists in the country today, I would imagine.
You know, I'm happy to say that our staff is really proud of what they do and what they watch. And of course, we're monitored by animals stuff on campus too, so you know we have to be accountable for stuff. And you know, with this system, we can really keep a closer eye on the cows than we have before.
And as we move into the future, we know that the successful farmers are the ones who are going to embrace technology, and we want to make certain that all the areas of agriculture in South Carolina can remain strong and healthy. And this is an example of how dairy can continue for centuries to come, I hope.
Yeah, I think so. And plus, even the South Carolina dairymen and even the dairymen in the Southeast are interested in what's going on with these systems. They're looking at them, you know.
Well, if people want to know more about this fascinating experiment and facility that's here, what's the best way to get information?
You can go to our Clemson Research Farms website, and the dairy farm has its own website within that that has information from contacting me, my system manager, or any way you can get contact to get information.
Thank you for sharing this with us today. It really has been an extraordinary journey.
You're welcome. Enjoyed it.